It seems peaceful, but this is the very spot where a lot of Christians believe life on Earth will end. The irony of religion is that because of its power to divert man to destructive courses, the world actually could come to an end.
A lot of people in this country believe in end times. There will be this great reckoning, the rapture. Do you believe that?
I do.
But if you believe that the world is going to come to an end, and perhaps any day now, does it not drain one's motivation to improve life on Earth while we're here?
Plain fact is, religion must die for mankind to live. The hour is getting very late to be able to indulge in having key decisions made by religious people, by irrationalists, by those who would steer the ship of state not by a compass, but by the equivalent of reading the entrails of a chicken. George Bush prayed a lot about Iraq, but he didn't learn a lot about it.
I don't know much about politics, but I'll vote for President Bush because of his faith.
Faith means making a virtue out of not thinking. It's nothing to brag about. And those who preach faith and enable and elevate it are our intellectual slaveholders, keeping mankind in a bondage to fantasy and nonsense that has spawned and justified so much lunacy and destruction. Religion is dangerous because it allows human beings who don't have all the answers to think that they do. Most people would think it's wonderful when someone says, "I'm willing, Lord. I'll do whatever you want me to do." Except that since there are no gods actually talking to us,
please,
that void is filled in by people with their own corruptions and limitations and agendas.
It's going to happen, and I'm not saying necessarily nuclear. The Lord didn't say nuclear, but I do believe it'll be something like that.
And anyone who tells you they know, they just know what happens when you die, I promise you, you don't. How can I be so sure? Because I don't know, and you do not possess mental powers that I do not. The only appropriate attitude for man to have about the big questions is not the arrogant certitude that is the hallmark of religion, but doubt. Doubt is humble, and that's what man needs to be, considering that human history is just a litany of getting shit dead wrong.
Jesus is coming back to rescue the Jews because he is the only one that can.
The believer goes in the paradise, and believer, they will go to the hell.
The Jews are the only reason that I am a Christian. I love them.
But you're not going to take them up to heaven with you, are you?
I'm going to go in the rapture, and I'm going to come back on a white horse.
So you think Jesus will end this earth at some point, maybe in your lifetime?
One always hopes.
Right.
This is a sign and that is a sign.
But I mean, if a nuclear bomb went off and it seemed like that was exactly what it had said, balls of fire or something, you wouldn't look on that as necessarily a bad thing.
I know I'll be with God.
This is why rational people, anti-religionists, must end their timidity and come out of the closet and assert themselves. And those who consider themselves only moderately religious really need to look in the mirror and realize that the solace and comfort that religion brings you actually comes at a terrible price.
It says in the last days there'll be wars, rumors of wars.
The Bible prophecies from the book of Revelation, they're going to be fulfilled.
Can this be accomplished without violence?
No.
Islam ruling the world, global jihad.
Who will win out?
We'll win.
That's for God to decide on Judgment Day.
If you belong to a political party or a social club that was tied to as much bigotry, misogyny, homophobia, violence, and sheer ignorance as religion is, you'd resign in protest. To do otherwise is to be an enabler, a mafia wife, for the true devils of extremism that draw their legitimacy from the billions of their fellow travelers. If the world does come to an end here or wherever, or if it limps into the future, decimated by the effects of a religion-inspired nuclear terrorism, let's remember what the real problem was. That we learned how to precipitate mass death before we got past the neurological disorder of wishing for it. That's it. Grow up or die.
We are in a conflict between good and evil.